Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Since January, I have been privileged to serve the people of Georgia's 6th Congressional District. When I was a small child, my family instilled in me the importance of service and building community. And as I've grown in life, I have held many roles: daughter, wife, working mother, but I never imagined Congresswoman would be one of them. My goals were the same as many other Americans. I wanted to start a family and raise a caring, compassionate child. Like many women, I struggled to get pregnant. And after years of trying, my son Jordan was a miracle for me, for our family. I dreamed of who Jordan would become. I dreamed of watching him walk across the stage at his high school graduation, full of love and hope for the future. I dreamed of him carrying on our family's legacy of public service. But 7 years ago, on a day much like today, Jordan was sitting in the back seat of a car with his friends at a gas station. A man pulled up next to their car and complained about the loud music that they were playing. He pulled out a gun and fired 10 shots into their car, hitting Jordan 3 times and killing my only son. I found myself asking God, how could this happen? How did he allow this to happen to me, to my family, and to Jordan? I prayed to God and found the strength to forgive my killer. I stood up for families like mine. I stood up for families in Marietta, Georgia, who were terrified that they will send their kids to school and never see them come home. I stood up for the teens who sent texts to their parents in Parkland, Florida. I stood up for their mothers reading messages from their children that pled, "If I don't make it home, I love you and thank you for everything that you've done for me." I made a promise to my community that I would act. I promised that I would take that sense of protection, that love a mother has for her son, and I would use it for my community, for the American people. I promised I would work with the president when his policies are right for Georgia and stand up to him when they are not. And I am proud of our progress. I am proud to have passed bills that protect our communities. I am proud to have written a bill that was signed into law by President Trump, a bill that protects our veterans. But I am not proud of the president's actions that bring us here tonight. For months, we have carefully and methodically explored the facts. I have listened to our witnesses, I've examined the evidence from our intelligence community, and I've heard from the brave men and women who have dedicated their lives in service to our country, both at home and abroad. I am greatly saddened by what we have learned, and I am forced to face a solemn conclusion. I believe the president abused the power of his office, putting his own interests above the needs of our nation, above the needs of the people that I love and I serve. And for that, I must vote my conscience. And I do so with a heavy heart and a grieving soul. This is not why I came to Washington. I came to Washington because I love my country. I came to Washington full of hope, empowered by my community to serve them in Congress, and it is an honor to carry out this work every single day to make sure that no one else goes through the same pain that I have. But after this vote, I will continue to champion the ideals this country instilled in me to stand up for the safety and security of our communities and to fight for an America I prayed that my son, Jordan, would be proud of.